Thank you. said, I do not think it will be possible to bring them all under the same heading. There are savages, there are mechanized people, there are intellectual people, there are geniuses. The real difference between people you do not know and cannot see. The difference which you speak simply does not exist. This must be understood. All the people you see, all the people you know, all the people you may get to know, are machines, actual machines working solely under the power. Such a machine as it was before. It already begins to be responsible for its actions. This means, according to you, that a man is not responsible for his actions. I asked. A man, he emphasized this word, is responsible. A machine is not responsible. In the course of one of our talks I asked G. What, in your opinion, is the best preparation for the study of your method? For instance, is it useful to study what is called occult or mystical literature? In saying this, I had in mind more particularly the tarot and the literature on the tarot. Yes, said G, a great deal can be found by reading. For instance, take yourself. You might already know a great deal if you knew how to read. I mean that, if you understood everything you have read in your life, already know what you are looking for now. If you understood everything you have written in your own book, what is it called? He made something altogether impossible out of the words, tertium organum, I should come and bow down to you and beg you to teach me. But you do not understand either what you read or what you write. You do not even understand what the word, understand, means. Yet understanding is essential, and reading can be useful only if you understand what you read. But, of course, no book can give real preparation. So it is impossible to say which is better. What a man knows well, he emphasized the word, well, that is his preparation. If a man knows how to make coffee well or how to make boots well, then it is already possible to talk to him. The trouble is that nobody knows anything well. Everything is known just anyhow, superficially. This was another of those unexpected turns which G gave to his explanations. G's words, in addition to their ordinary meaning, undoubtedly contained another, altogether different, meaning. I had already begun to realize that, in order to arrive at this hidden meaning in G's words, one had to begin with their usual and simple meaning. G's words were always significant in their ordinary sense, although this was not the whole of their significance. The wider or deeper significance remained hidden for a long time. There is another talk which has remained in my memory. I asked G what a man had to do to assimilate this teaching. What to do? Asked G as though surprised. It is impossible to do anything. A man must first of all understand certain things. He has thousands of false ideas and false conceptions, chiefly about himself, and he must get rid of some of them before beginning to acquire anything new. Otherwise the new will be built on a wrong foundation and the result will be worse than before. How can one get rid of false ideas? I ask, we depend on the forms of our perception. False ideas are produced by the forms of our perception. G shook his head. Again you speak of something different, he said. You speak of errors arising from perceptions, but I am not speaking of these. Within the limits of given perceptions, man can err more or err less. As I have said before, man's chief delusion is his conviction that he can do. All people think that they can do, all people want to do, and the first question all people ask is what they are to do. But actually nobody does anything and nobody can do anything. This is the first thing that must be understood. Everything happens. All that befalls a man, all that is done by him, all that comes from him, all this happens. And it happens in exactly the same way as rain falls as a result of a change in the temperature in the higher regions of the atmosphere or the surrounding clouds, as snow melts under the rays of the sun, as dust rises with the wind. Man is a machine. All his deeds, actions, words, thoughts, feelings, convictions, opinions, and habits are the results of external influences, external impressions. Out of himself a man cannot produce a single thought, a single action. Everything he says, does, thinks, feels, all this happens. Man cannot discover anything, invent anything, it all happens. To establish this fact for oneself, to understand it, to be convinced of its truth, means getting rid of a thousand illusions about man, about his being creative and consciously organizing his own life, and so on. There is nothing of this kind. Everything happens. Popular movements, wars, revolutions, changes of government, all this happens. And it happens in exactly the same way as everything happens in the life of individual man. Man is born, lives, dies, builds houses, writes books, not as he wants to, but as it happens. Everything happens. Man does not love, hate, desire, all this happens. But no one will ever believe you if you tell him he can do nothing. This is the most offensive and the most unpleasant thing you can tell people. It is particularly unpleasant and offensive because it is the truth, and nobody wants to know the truth. When you understand this, it will be easier for us to talk. But it is one thing to understand with your mind and another thing to feel with one whole mass, to be really convinced that it is so and never forget it. With this question of doing, G emphasized the word yet another thing is connected. It always seems to people that others invariably do things wrongly, not in the way they should be done. Everybody always thinks he could do it better. They do not understand, and do not want to understand, that what is being done, and particularly what has already been done in one way, cannot be, and could not have been, done in another way. Have you noticed how everyone now is talking about the war? Everyone has his own plan, his own theory. Everyone finds that nothing is being done in the way it ought to be done. Actually, everything is being done in the only way it can be done. If one thing could be fair and everything could be different, and then perhaps there would have been no war. Try to understand what I am saying. Everything is dependent on everything else. Everything is connected.